Good morning, everyone, and thank you for the invitation. I just opened my video to greet everyone, but I need to close because the internet where I stay is not very strong.
Dakle, dobro jutro svima, želim vas pozdraviti. Samo bih napomenula da internet ovdje nije baš najbolji, tako da... Yes.
My presentation, it's our struggle of over 21 years to stop the Mphanda Nkuwa dam in the Zambezi River.
Dakle, moja prezentacija se tiče naše borbe duge više od 21 godinu da se zaustavi izgradnja Mphanda Nkuwa brane na rijeci Zambezi.
I'm sure everyone knows what is a dam, a large and a mega dam.
Mislim da svi znate šta je brana, šta je velika brana i mega brana.
It is a cement wall that stops the course of the river.
To je zapravo zid izgrađen od cementa koji zaustavlja tok rijeke.
And a very interesting issue is the meaning of the word in Greek.
Vrlo interesantno pitanje je zapravo samo značenje riječi brana na grčkom jeziku.
It means a grave. A grave hill, so it is a tombstone for the river.
Ona zapravo na grčkom jeziku znači grob ili to je i na neki način predstavlja dakle grob, onu grobnicu za rijeku.
In reality, it's the dead of the river and the communities and ecosystems.
U stvarnosti ona znači smrt rijeke, zajednica oko njih i ekosistema.
Next slide, please. Between 1930 and 17, there was a boom of mega dams. It was the representation of economic
Sorry, can you repeat? Haven't heard you.
Between 1930 and 70, it mm-hmm. was a boom of mega dams. It means at the time economic development.
Da, u periodu od 1930-70 je došlo do pravog buma ovih mega brana, jer se u to doba smatralo da je to znak ekonomskog razvoja.
In that period, 50% of all the rivers in the world were blocked by dams.
I u tom konkretnom periodu više od 50% svjetskih rijeka su blokirane branama.
Next slide, please. So the impacts of the dams on the ecosystems, the life of the river and on the communities that depend so much on the river for their livelihood.
Tako da je uticaj brana na život na rijeke i zajednica koje ovise o njima.
Become an issue that civil society raise up and they start fighting against the dams.
Je zapravo postalo pitanje za civilno društvo i oni su otpočeli borbu protiv izgradnje brana.
Studies were made that proved that dams, although it help on development, it is much more worry on their impacts.
Sorry, the last part of the sentence?
Very worry about their impacts.
Da, i na kraju, dakle, došlo je do toga da je zapravo došlo do velike zabrinutosti vezano za utjecaj brana koje zapravo nisu uspjele da budu odgovor u smislu ekonomskog razvoja. Yes?
A movement against dams stopped all over the world.
And I, sorry, u cijelom svijetu počeo je ovaj pokret u borbi protiv brana i zaustavljanju njihove izgradnje.
Next slide, please. There's some facts about existing dam. I'm sure everyone knows, but I'll go quickly on some of them.
Dakle, postoje neki utjecaj brana za koje vjerujem da ste, za koje vjerujem da ste ih svi svjesni, međutim, ja ću vrlo brzo proći kroz neke od njih.
Those few facts are in every dam. It's a fact.
I znači ove činjenice koje ću sad nabrojati tiču se svake brane i to jeste istina, to je činjenica.
50% does not reach economic goal.
Dakle, 50% njih uopće ne uspijeva da ispuni svoj ekonomski cilj.
20% of the more than 9,000 species of fish have become extinct.
20% od više od 9000 vrsta riba su izumrle.
Reduce soil fertility.
Brane smanjuju plodnost tla.
Reduce fish reproduction.
Dakle, smanjuju reprodukciju ribljeg fonda.
Increase erosion.
Povećavaju eroziju.
As a huge impact on agriculture.
Nemaju utjecaj, dakle imaju negativan utjecaj na poljoprivredu.
Although it comes with the tag of controlling floods, it's just a lie because the impacts are much worse.
I iako je se govori da su one zapravo alatka za kontrolu poplava, to je zapravo laž.
Breaks the natural flow of the river.
Dakle, njima se prekida i ukida prirodni tok rijeka.
Blocks 90% of the sediment of the river, that the sediment is the food of the river.
Blokira otprilike 90% sedimenata, riječnih sedimenata koji zapravo predstavljaju hranu rijeka.
And is responsible for 63% at least of displacement of populations all over the world.
I dakle, odgovorni su za gotovo 63% raseljavanja stanovništva u svijetu.
And increase the seismic risk.
I povećava se seizmički rizik. A na dijalektu Tonga koji se govori u Mozambiku, koji govore narodi Mozambika, samo ime znači velika rijeka.
And it's as the Victoria Fall.
I naravno na njoj su čuveni viktorijeni vodopadi.
And I'm sure everyone know it's an old heritage site on the Zambezi River. It's amazing.
I mislim da svi znamo da je to znači spomenik prirode ili prirodnog nasljeđa na rijeci Zambezi.
It's estimated that 32 million people live on the Zambezi River banks.
Mm-hmm. Dakle, procijenjeno da negdje oko 32 miliona ljudi živi na obalama Zambezija.
80% depends directly to the river for their livelihood.
Mm-hmm. Od kojih 80% njih direktno ovisi o samoj rijeci za preživljavanje.
Based on agriculture, fishing and any more activities.
I to zbog toga što se bave poljoprivredom, ribarstvom i nekim vezanim za to aktivnostima.
Next. The life of millions of people.
I te dvije brane su znači uništile ekosistem i zapravo promijenile život miliona ljudi.
The hydroelectric of Cabora Bassa in Mozambique, all the energy produced is exported for South Africa as a cost of peanuts, and then a bit is sold back to Mozambique at a very high cost.
Dakle, sva energija koja se proizvede, sva hidroenergija koja se proizvede na ovim branama se izvozi u Južnu Afriku za kikiriki, kako se kaže pod navodnicima, a onda se vrlo mala količina energije ponovo vraća u Mozambik u znatno veću cijenu.
Taking in consideration that 70% of the Mozambique population does not have energy.
Imajući to na umu, trebamo znati da 70% stanovništva Mozambika još uvijek nema električnu energiju.
Without addressing the problems of the Cabora Bassa and without having plans how to supply energy to the Mozambican people, our government decide to build another dam.
Dakle, u nastojanju da se riješi problem snabdjevanja, problem rješenja energije za naše stanovništvo, i bez obzira na Cabora Bassa, naše vlasti su dakle odlučile da izgrade još jednu branu.
The dam Mphanda Nkuwa would be built 7 kilometers downstream of Cabora Bassa.
I Mphanda Nkuwa, ova brana će biti izgrađena 7 kilometara nizvodno od Cabora Bassa.
The name Mphanda Nkuwa means where the lions cross.
A samo ime Mphanda Nkuwa zapravo bukvalno znači mjesto gdje lavovi prelaze rijeku.
Because long ago the lions will cross, because it's a very narrow part of the river, the lions will jump and cross.
Razlog tome je što je sudavno lavovi tu prelazili rijeku, budući da se radi o vrlo uskom dijelu rijeke.
Next slide, please. When we find out about the government wanted to build another dam, we were worried.
Kad smo saznali da vlada planira da izgradi još jednu branu, to nas je zabrinulo.
Many questions come to our mind.
Mnogo pitanja smo počeli da postavljamo.
Why?
Dakle, zašto?
The energy will be exported. What benefits will we have?
Dakle, električna energija će se izvoziti. Kakve to benefite ćemo mi imati?
Why you need a dam so near another one?
Zašto nam je potrebna brana tako blizu druge brane?
What were the country energy needs?
Koje su energetske potrebe naše zemlje?
What benefits the country and the people have, and what will be the price to pay?
Dakle, koje su to koristi zemlja koje će imati ljudi i zemlja i po koju cijenu?
So with all those questions, we start doing research. We start meeting with academics and many specialists.
I da bismo odgovorili na sva ta pitanja, počeli smo istraživanja, počeli smo se redovito sastajati sa akademicima, naučnicima.
At the time, there was working groups that academics and researchers that wanted to change the flow of Cabora Bassa.
U to doba, dakle, radna grupa sastavljena akademika i istraživača je željela da izmijeni tok, da izmijeni ovu Mphanda Nkuwa.
Because of the impacts that Kabarabasa had on the wetlands,
mm-hmm.
because it became a Ramsar site, a site very special that needs to be kept. And to be kept, we need water.
Dakle, i htjeli su, dakle, oprostite, radi se o tome da su htjeli promijeniti mjesto Kabore Hase, budući da ima veliki utjecaj na vlažno stanište koje, da biste zadržali, morate imati vodu.
We decided to visit the site and talk to the communities.
Dakle, onda smo donijeli odluku da ćemo posjetiti samu lokaciju, mjesto i razgovarati sa ljudima iz lokalnih zajednica.
We find out they didn't have hardly any information.
Saznali smo da oni zapravo jedva da imaju ikakve informacije.
The little they know was only promise of jobs.
Sorry?
The only information they had was mm-hmm. promise of jobs.
Jedina informacija koju su imali je obećanje o potencijalnim poslovima.
And they will be relocated and they will receive money for that.
I činjenica da će biti izmješteni, te da će zato biti im isplaćena financijska naknada.
They didn't have any idea the impacts they are not going to live near the river. Absolutely nothing.
I oni nisu imali nikakve informacije o činjenici da neće živjeti blizu rijeke, dakle nikakve informacije o tom životu koji više neće biti blizu rijeke.
One very important thing in Mozambique is that most of the rural community do not talk Portuguese well.
Dakle, jedna od vrlo važnih činjenica u ruralnim zajednicama Mozambika je da oni ne govore dobro jezik.
Although after independence, Portugal. The language of the country is Portuguese.
Mm-hmm. Iako je oficijalni jezik, dakle službeni jezik zemlje portugalski.
We have over 20 dialects through the country.
Dakle, u cijeloj zemlji ima preko 20 dijalekata koji se govore.
And most government and even anyone on civil society know more than one.
Mm-hmm. Most government and no more, can you?
And civil society.
Prosti. Većina ljudi zapravo govori samo jedan od tih 20 dijalekata, pa uključujući i neke od dužnosnika.
So when any project comes to a rural area, they need translated. And the lost is lose on translator, or ever is proper or not, we never find out.
Radi se o tome da kad god želite da razgovarate u lokalnoj zajednici, treba vam prevodilac. Dosta toga se izgubi u prijevodu ono što im se obećava, to mi zapravo nikad ne saznamo šta im se kaže.
Next slide, please.
Sljedeći.
So we start a campaign against the dam.
Tako da smo započeli kampanju protiv brane.
We inform the communities about the negative impacts and the possible benefits if they will have.
Mm-hmm. Dakle, informirali smo lokalne zajednice o negativnim utjecajima kao i o mogućim koristima do kojih će možda doći.
We conducted training on laws. Our constitution.
Dakle, proveli smo obuku, ajmo reći seminare vezano za zakone, ustav.
The land law and the odd order rights.
Zakon o zemljištu kao i pravima lokalnih zajednica.
For 21 years we never stopped working with the communities At the same time, we work on the capital by raising awareness.
Dakle, u toku 21 godine nikad nismo prestali da radimo sa lokalnim zajednicama. Istovremeno smo, dakle, stecali kapital u smislu stvaranja svijesti.
We did the research, and every research we did, we'll present to the communities.
Isto tako
by theater, mm-hmm. by music, in different ways, and also in books, and translated in the dialect when possible.
Dakle, uradili smo istraživanja i sva ta istraživanja koja smo, svi rezultati koje istraživanja koja smo napravili su bili predstavljeni u lokalnim zajednicama, bilo kroz muziku, bilo kroz knjige, na bilo koji način, i također smo se potrudili da to prevedemo na dijalekt.
We did petitions to the parliament.
Upućivali smo peticije parlamentu.
We constantly wrote articles.
Konstantno smo pisali članke u novin, u publikacijama, novinama.
We had two focal groups.
Imali smo dvije focus grupe.
We had the communities that we support and we raise their voice and we explain what are their rights and listen to what they need.
Dakle, imali smo lokalne zajednice koje smo slušali, koje, za koje smo nastojali da se njihov glas čuje.
And we had the civil society, governments, and decision make in the, at the national level.
Isto tako imali smo vladu, predstavnike građanskog društva i na međunarodnom nivou. I one koji donose odluke na međunarodnom nivou.
To bring the reality on the field, on the rural area, to the capital.
Mm-hmm. Kako bismo, kako bismo prenijeli realnost koja se dešava na terenu do glavnog grada, dakle u glavni grad, u prijestolnicu. Yes.
To show them how horrible this development is. Although most of the people 21 years ago look to the building of the dam of development, they still very much supporting dams.
Dakle, kako bismo, dakle, na neki način stavili da se vidi koliko strašni utjecaj će biti brane, međutim, i nakon 21 godine ovih napora još uvijek ima jako puno ljudi koji smatraju kako je to, koji blagonaklono gledaju na izgradnju brana.
We did the photo exhibition to connect the rural people to the city to show them what will be the impact of the dam.
Radili smo foto izložbe kako bismo pokazali ruralnim zajednicama i u gradovima kakvi utjecaji će biti brane.
We had action days every year. We put outdoors to call attention.
Dakle, imamo te takozvane dane akcija koji se odvijaju vani.
And you try to get as much attention as possible to the media.
I pokušavamo skrenuti što je više moguće pažnje medija na ovo.
Looking back 21 years ago and today,
dakle, ako gledamo na ono što je bilo prije 21 godinu i na situaciju koju imamo danas,
we can see the change that happened and the understanding of many people. The change that happened about this dam and this type of development to many
dakle,
people.
Dakle, možemo vidjeti promjenu kod mnogih ljudi, dakle promjenu koja se tiče u gledanju u stavu prema ovoj brani i blokiranju.
Can you change the next slide? those are some of the action we did. Mm-hmm. Next slide.
Ovo su neke od akcija koje su oni izveli.
More actions. And the photo on the left, it's how sometimes we present studies. We do theater to show the impacts of the dam.
Mm-hmm.
And on dakle, the photo, sorry.
Dakle, na lijevo, slika gore lijevo pokazuje na koji način mi pokušavamo prezentirati utjecaje brane. Nekad to radimo kroz jedan teatralan način, kao što vidite na ovoj fotografiji.
Okay. On the bottom, a car turnover.
Mm-hmm.
It was an accident we had on the way to do research, mm-hmm. but we didn't stop.
Dakle, dolje desno imate fotografiju prevrnutog automobila na našem putu. Da, vršimo istraživanja, doživjeli smo nesreću, međutim, to nas nije zaustavilo i nastavili smo.
We wait for hours on the road, and when a car came, we turn back the car and we carry on working.
Dakle, čekali smo satima da naiđe sljedeći automobil da nam pomogne prevrnuti auto natrag na cestu i onda smo nastavili sa svojim, sjeli u auto i nastavili sa poslom.
We did work for 20 days with no windows and taking chances on a car. And actually the car was mine and when we arrived in Maputo, we had to go to the scrapyard.
Dakle, ustrajali smo na tome, bili smo 20 dana na putu, usprkos svemu smo to odradili, zapravo to je moj lični auto bio i kad smo se vratili u grad, onda je završio na rezalištu, dakle na otpadu.
The middle banner, as you can see here, with mm-hmm. fisherman,
mm-hmm.
it says 20 years insisting. In a failed project, enough.
Dakle, a srednja slika u sredini, natpis je na portugalskom i znači 20 godina insistiranja na projektu koji je propast, dosta.
This banner was posted in the Maputo, in the capital this year, and mm-hmm. the government wanted to take it out.
Dakle, ovo je poster koji smo postavili u Mubutu, glavnom gradu, i koji su organi vlasti htjeli skinuti.
In Mozambique you have to ask authorization and you pay to put something outdoors. And now we're going to have difficulties to put anything because no one wants to put anything for Gja because they're scared of government.
Dakle, u Mozambiku morate imati odobrenje, ovlaštenje da postavljate bilo kakvu vrstu obavještenja, a zbog svega ovoga što smo mi uradili, mi sad imamo poteškoće, jer ljudi zapravo se boje da postave bilo šta.
Next slide. During this 21 years, the projects mm-hmm. went through many phases.
U toku ove 21 godine ovaj projekat je prošao kroz niz faza.
Many companies, many investors.
Bilo je mnogo kompanija, mnogo investitora.
Government looking for funds.
Vlada je također pokušavala naći sredstva.
Many studies behind doors.
Urađene su mnoge studije i to, da tako kažemo, tajno, iza zatvorenih vrata.
And due to our partnership with European and American International River Groups.
A zahvaljujući našem partnerstvu sa američkim i evropskim grupama za zaštitu rijeka,
we find many of the information about where the government wanted to ask for funding.
I zapravo smo tim putem prikupili mnogo informacija o nastojanju vlade u Mubutu da sakupi sredstva za branu.
And we managed to bring many of the concerns we have about the stem.
I na neki način uspjeli smo da okupimo ljude koji se brinu o ovakvim stvarima, koji su jeli zabrinuti zbog ovakvih stvari.
So a few failures of moving forward with this project.
Tako da je bilo nekoliko, da tako kažemo, neuspjeha u pokušaju da se ovaj projekat progura ili odradi.
In 2009, the government created a consortium of Mphanda Nkuwa.
Dakle, 2009. Naša vlada je stvorila, formirala konzorciji Mphanda Nkuwa River.
A Brazilian company Camar Correia, 40%.
Dakle, tu su učestvovali brazilska kompanija Camargo Correia sa 40% udjela.
Electricity of Mozambique, 20%.
Elektroprivreda, da tako kažemo, Mozambika, 20%.
And a Mozambican group, EasyTech, that was a group with government people.
I mozambička grupa koju su činili ljudi iz vlade.
40%.
40%.
The problem in Mozambique is that the government people are the one, also the business people, there's this lack of principles and a lot of corruption.
Dakle, problem u Mozambiku je što su ljudi u vladi istovremeno ljudi I koji su poslovni ljudi, tako da imate kombinaciju nedostatka principa I strašnu korupciju.
So the process starts all over again for the environmental impact assessment.
Tako da je postupak vezan za utjecaj ekološki utjecaj na okoliš ponovo otpočeo.
Next slide. During the process we got involved, we advised, we asked for studies. There's a lot of seismic risk.
Mm-hmm. Mi smo u tom samom procesu, dakle, uradili mnogo studija, govorili smo o seizmičkom riziku, odnosno opasnosti.
There were studies that we demanded, seismic sediments and an analysis where the people are going to be relocated. None of this was done.
None?
All the studies we asked to be okay. done during the year, we're not done.
Dakle, tokom godina zahtijevali smo, dakle, niz studija, odnosno tražili smo da se izradi niz studija, naročito vezano za utjecaj I činjenicu ovog seizmičkog rizika, kao I to gdje će zapravo biti stanovništvo preseljeno. Yes?
In 2011, the mm-hmm. environmental impact assessment was approved.
2011. Odobrena je procjena utjecaja na okoliš.
With the note that if the impacts could be minimized, mm-hmm. the project will be a good project.
Sa napomenom koja je uvrštena u istu studiju, da a ukoliko se uspije da se minimazira ili smanje na najmanju moguću mjeru ti utjecaj, da će projekt... yes?
We did press release and complaints to the government, criticizing the weakness of the scientific studies. There were no conclusive proof.
Dakle, mi smo uradili pres konferenciju, uputili pritužbe vladi, žaleći se na činjenicu da naučne studije nisu imale konkluzivne, dakle, nekakve preporuke zaključne.
But that's typical in our country, everything was ignored.
Međutim, kao što je tipično u našoj zemlji, sve to je bilo izignorisano.
And looking for funding stopped.
I počeli su da traže sredstva za izgradnju.
Again, but they could not get funding.
I ponovo, dakle, su bili u tom procesu, međutim, nisu uspjeli da pronađu sredstva.
Then there was this big scandal, and I think everyone knows in Brazil, that...
Just a second. A onda je, mislim da smo svi svjesni ili čuli za veliki skandal koji se desio u Brazilu, yes?
That Brazilian company, Camar Correia, had a scandal, so everything stopped the funding and does mm-hmm. a silence for a while.
I zbog tog skandala u koji je bila upletena ova brazilska firma, sve je stalo I finansiranje I sve ostalo.
In 2018,
mm-hmm.
a new consortium was created and Mozambique came up in public, the president informing mm-hmm. that Mphanda Nkuwa is back as priority.
A 2018. Opet je oformljen novi konzorcij, mozambički predsjednik je u javnosti izjavio da ovaj projekat je ponovo aktivan I da se ide s njim.
This time, Mozambique lower company with attachment to a Portuguese company,
mm-hmm.
an Australia and an American company.
Ovaj put se radilo o, o mozambičkoj firmi, zatim McKenzie, ona je rekla australska, iz Australije. Dakle, ovaj put su bile te kompanije uključene u konzorci.
And they create an office
mm-hmm.
that for two years we try to make a meeting
mm-hmm.
and we never manage. Only in May of 2021. And we nicknamed the cabinet the ghost office and we made an action in the media mm-hmm. with the ghost as a photo you can see there.
Dakle, oni su, dakle, ovaj novi konzorcij je otvorio I kancelariju. U dvije godine naših nastojanja da se s njima zakaže sastanak nismo uspjeli, tako da smo mi to nazvali ghost, dakle, kancelarija ili kancelarija koja ne postoji, prividna. I u maju, I tako je to bilo sve do maja 2021.
Above. All the things we do, what does all years more, it's the suffering during 21 years of the communities, because they cannot do anything. In 2009,
mm-hmm.
They were told by the government that the dam will be built, and they mm-hmm. could not build houses, they could not do anything. There's mm-hmm. no school, no health, nothing. The community is just stuck with nothing. Mm-hmm.
Da, dakle, iznad svega u ovih 21 godina najstrašnije je bilo zapravo problemi, odnosno, da tako kažemo, patnje lokalnog stanovništva, jer 2009. Kad je objavljena početak izgradnje, od tada pa do danas, dakle, ovo stanovništvo ne može graditi kuće, ne može uraditi ništa, pomjeriti ništa, na neki način su zaglavljeni u tom vremenu jer im se ne dozvoljava bilo kakva aktivnost.
They're living with the cloud on top of them. They're going to lose the little they have.
I, dakle, na neki način žive u tom oblaku koji se nadvija nad njima I izgubit će I ono malo što imaju.
At the same time, those years, many investments came to the province of that.
Istovremeno, situacija je bila da su u toku svih tih godina mnogi investitori dolazili u ovu provinciju.
And they know they will not going to get any better if this project's going to be built.
I oni znaju da, dakle, da zapravo tu neće se ništa desiti ukoliko ovaj projekt se ostvari.
They will not have energy because the energy of this project is not for the people. It's again to export.
Dakle, taj projekat nije o energiji, ta energija nije nešto što je namijenjeno za narod, to je jedan, treba da postigne jedan brzi rezultat, dakle brzi efekat.
They're gonna probably be relocated. They're gonna be relocated far away from the river.
Biće premješteni I to jako daleko od rijeke.
When all they know is fish and agriculture near the river. The river is their life.
A pritome sve što ti ljudi znaju raditi u životu je ribarenje I obrada zemljišta uz samu rijeku. Rijeka je zapravo njihov život.
So they don't want them and they ask. So we making at this moment, you are doing another petition.
Mm-hmm.
Can you go to the next slide?
Tako da oni ne žele ovu branu, mi ćemo, mi krećemo sa novom peticijom.
And everything that's happened this last 15 years on the development on a province.
I pritome, znači, izgubljeno je 15 godina mogućnosti razvoja ove konkretne provincije.
People are bit by bit raising their voice and stop being scared of the government.
I ljudi still, malo pomalo podižu svoj glas i prestaju se bojati vlade.
As you can see the message on the action day we did, you can go to the next slide.
I kao što vidite poruku na dan kada smo imali akciju, pravo da se kaže ne.
Next slide. They ask, they don't want. One of the things they wrote, it's we eat fish, we don't eat dams.
Dakle, ovo su poruke koje su oni napisali u toj akciji. Na jednoj od tih poruka piše, mi jedemo ribu, ne brane.
The Zambezi is our life.
Zambezi je naš život.
Please respect our willingness, what we want.
I molimo vas da poštujete našu volju, dakle ono što želimo.
The Zambezi is my life. Mphanda Nkuwa now.
Zambezi je moj život, to je ovo Mphanda Nkuwa naj.
And many other message, can you go to the next?
I mnogo, mnogo drugih poruka je stiglo.
It's clear that the message, this is a Jatim, it's clear that the message, it's no. There was no doubt. But during those years, they had problems because the leaders are the people that deal with the government. Mm-hmm. And his leaders was brought, was corrupt by the government. Mm-hmm. And this year, they changed the leader. They had the courage to take out the other leader.
Dakle, radi se o tome da je poruka sasvim jasna, ne brani, i radi se o tome da smo ove godine konačno uspjeli da promijenimo vođu zajednice, budući da se radilo o korumpiranoj osobi, dakle, smogli smo snage da i to uradimo.
The most important thing we all have all over, it's we need to break the narrative on dams, because now dams are coming back with the tag of solutions for climate change.
Da, i ono što svi moramo uraditi je da ukinemo tu priču, dakle taj narativ vezan za brane, jer one se ponovo, izgradnja brana se ponovo vraća u sklopu pitanja klimatskih promjena.
Next slide. Next. I don't know if you want me to go carry on, because I'm sure everyone knows about dams and the emissions of methane.
Dakle, ne znam da li da nastavim, budući da mislim da svi znate vezu između brana i emisije CO2.
And all I, it is such a big lie to tell that dams are solution for climate change.
I samo mogu reći da je sve to laž, da brane kao rješenje za klimatske promjene, to je najveća laž koja postoji.
Next slide. Specific on the Zambezi, the IPCC has many reports to prove that the Zambezi is one of the rivers with more risk of floods and drought. So building a dam in the Zambezi is the stupidest thing any person
izgradnja brane na Zambeziju je glupost. Obzirom da je rijeka Zambezi, prema studijama, rezultat bi bio smanjenje kiša, veće suše, smanjen protok tog.
Next slide. That's, we only did study on the river and on the impacts of people. We also did study of the alternatives energy that Mozambique could have, decentralize and just for everyone, and the government ignored completely.
Mi smo dakle uradili studiju o rijeci, isto tako smo uradili i studije vezano za alternative koje bi Mozambik u smislu energije mogao primijeniti. Naročito smo se zalagali za decentralizirana rješenja vezano za obezbjeđenje energije u u zajednicama u Africi.
We did a study about the impacts of Kabarabasa on the daily life with the floods of the communities.
Mi smo isto tako radili i studiju vezano o utjecaju Kabarabase na svakodnevni život zajednica koje se nalaze u tom području.
And many others also we did cartoons with information.
Isto tako smo radili ove crtane, ove stripove vezano na, u kojima smo dali informaciju.
But the reality is one, we don't need dams. And we need decentralized energy solution for Africa that is just and accessible to everyone.
Dakle, međutim, stvarnost je ovakva. Nama brane ne trebaju ponovo, trebamo decentralizirana energetska rješenja za zajednice u Africi.
Next slide. So, for me and many of us around the world, we don't understand why build dams and for whom and not.
Dakle, za mene i jako mnogo ljudi diljem svijeta, ja to naprosto ne razumijem. Zašto izgraditi brane, za koga i šta?
It's what I call a million dollar question. Because it's not for us, the people, is no solution for climate change crisis.
Mm-hmm. Dakle, to je ono pitanje koje ja zovem pitanje od milion dolara, zato što se ne radi o tome da se te brane grade za nas kao narod. To nije rješenje klimatske krize, nije u korist okoliša.
And for sure is not for us, either for the environmental. So we need to stop dams all over.
Tako da, budući da je to tako, moramo u potpunosti zaustaviti izgradnju brana.
But we need to fight dams taking in consideration the contest. The contest of capitalism, and we need to fight the system. It's the system that brings those false solutions to us and to the people.
Da zapravo radi se o tome da imajući na umu ovu izgradnju brana, mi se zapravo trebamo, ne borimo se protiv kapitalizma, nego protiv samog sistema koji to nameće.
We need to carry on fighting until no dams will be built in Africa and elsewhere.
Moramo nastaviti svoju borbu sve dotle dok niti jedna brana više se ne izgradi u Africi i na drugim mjestima.
Next slide. We need to link our struggles and we cannot give up because a dam project is something that doesn't go in the first battle. It'll come back and come back. And this is a typical example. 21 years.
Dakle, mi moramo udružiti naše borbe i ne smemo nikada odustati, budući da se ovakvi projekti vezani za brane naprosto vraćaju i vraćaju i vraćaju i evo govorimo o 21. godini borbe.
And it's very difficult struggle because when people, normal people are called people that don't have the understanding of the impacts, look at them, they see development.
Dakle, ta borba nije jednostavna, jer dakle, moramo doći u situaciju da obični ljudi zapravo vide na kraju da je ta brana blokirala, dakle da je to jedna blokada.
And it comes with so many lies and people believe.
Dakle, i da utiče, mijenja toliko života.
It's different when you look to a coal power station and you see the pollution, you see ugliness.
I sasvim je drugačije kad vidite termoelektranu i vidljivo je i zagađenje i sve ostalo.
So it's a much difficult struggle.
Tako da se ovdje radi o mnogo, mnogo težoj borbi.
But today, 21 years after.
Međutim, danas, 21 godinu poslije početka,
we break a bit of that wall of understanding.
Mi smo na neki način načeli taj zid razumijevanja.
Still not easy, but we need to carry on, never give up.
Dakle, i dalje nije lako, međutim moramo nastaviti, nikada ne odustajati.
We had threats, we had people telling us that they're gonna do things, we had attacks, we had many ugly things, but looking back, the moment you give up, you're losing. So that's the only message I can.
Dakle, glavna poruka koju vam mogu reći je dakle, da u svu ovu tehnologiju, sve ovo što imamo na raspolaganju, ključno je nikada ne odustajati, jer u momentu kad odustanete, izgubili ste bitku.
A luta continua. Thank you. Obrigada. And in the suit dialect, kalimambo.
Dakle, hvala vam. Obrigada je na portugalskom i ovo je dijalekt koji gospođa govori. Thank you very much.